I'm gonna make this quick this year. I'm raising money for Johns Hopkins Children's Center because they saved my oldest daughter's life twice, and my youngest children were in a NICU in a hospital that's affiliated with Johns Hopkins. So any amount of money that you can help me raise really means so much to me, because it really, my daughters would not be here, and my son would not be here without Johns Hopkins Children's Center. So you'll find links below, and thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.
It's time for the 25th Anniversary Civ Extravaganza. Hey guys, how's it going? Civ Extravaganza time. Let's get into it. Here we go. My son was, woke me up at 3:30 this morning. It's a little after 4:30 now. I couldn't go back to sleep. Today's gonna be a long day. To work on my domination victory. With these very ineffective catapults of the M63. There's a nice big city. Alright. Just a little more and then my place will be continuous, except this dude has a freaking a settler with him, so he might found something right freaking here and piss me off. Send this guy over here. From the later civs, being able to it's a pretty funny fight. Being able to know how well the fight's gonna go before you start it. But I guess that's a bit of an element of reality, right? People don't typically know how well a war's gonna go when they start a war. Alright, all you guys, let's go over here. So there's another settler over here, so pretty much anything that has been taken, AI might try and do something silly. Like there's some land up here, I guess, or something like that. Oh, there's like a little square right here. They found a square right in the middle of my territory and then complain about me. I'm going to be quite upset. Let's see what we got going on here. Alright. So I want to make sure my outer cities are protected. Let's get someone to London, just in case. Hopefully I'm getting close to their capital, so I can end this war. In Civ III, you gotta destroy every single city, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it's not just capitals. by the what they're wearing. This guy's probably gonna play. Nope. That's good. It's pretty awesome that they can withdraw. Rename this victorious unit. I'm the Chinese, huh? It's Mulan. Ooh, cool. I've got this dude. Guessing this is a guy that can start an army. It's been so long since I played Civ III. Pretty sure it has something to do with that. Alright. Beijing. Let's see here. Ooh. Make people happy? I like that. This city seems to have trouble with unhappiness all the time. And it looks like it can start making trebuchets soon. Hopefully way better than these stupid catapults. Alright, am I making enough money that I can raise my science again? Yes, I am. Excellent. Explore, sentry, go to destination, fortify, disband, wait. Must be something I can only do in my own territory or something like that. This guy up here. Alright, got more iron now, I guess. These guys are taking their sweet time to heal. They need to be in a city. I guess that was just a, whatchamacallit, military leader. Oh well. So disorder everywhere, huh? Quite a ways to go if I want domination. Same thing for culture. Looks like the Iroquois are my biggest chance of losing a domination. Okay. I guess there's the possibility that I end up winning the space race. I think I'm one of the most technologically advanced. I think these guys are going to settle beneath Buffalo or something. Alright, we've got the Great Lighthouse. Even though they're trying to settle everywhere, I think they're running out of places to settle. But I don't know how omniscient the AI is, if they're like, oh, that was open when we left, or if they always know where they're open to settle. And of course, there's this whole continent over here I guess we haven't discovered. Five 5 more minutes before I have to go make the milk for the kids. Alright, let's go to Beijing. What does this give me again? Ooh, I like this. I always used to build this one. I would actually try to race to get there. Alright, let's do it. Luna's workshop. Granary. Looks like riders and trebuchets are my best bet. Let me do a trebuchet, then a rider, then a marketplace, then a trebuchet, then a rider, then a trebuchet, then a rider. Alright. More or less all my, English ones were supposed to be scientific. These other things that'll help them be a little less inefficient. Palace. Okay. Nanking. Rider, trebuchet, rider. Art of War. They're probably never gonna get to that. So I'm losing 7 gold per turn, but that's okay for now. I've got 154 gold. I might take on that those Mexicans instead of going after Carthage again. Just want these two to connect so I don't have to worry about these settlers walking around everywhere. Dagnabbit, they beat me to the next Templar. I love that one because you just get these free units. Let's go up here and see what's up with the border. This is getting cooler and cooler. There we go. Let's do some reconnaissance here while I can. These frickin' bastards. That just means I'm gonna have to go to war with them. I've got no choice at this point. Uniforms. It's one of those great acknowledgments of the way that things worked in ancient times, where sometimes, I mean, even modern times, I guess, you know, people aren't always necessarily honest about that stuff. Treasury's running low again. Alright. Let's make another road over here. Ah, green is the Aztecs. So they're annoyed with me, but they want to trade, so we'll do that. Peace. The nice thing about Civ III and stacking is that when it comes to roads, I don't have to design the roads in a way that the units can't step on each other, right? So they can all kind of take the same road up. Alright, let's lower this. Alright guys, this has been Civ III as part of my Civ 25th Anniversary Extravaganza. It's pretty clear at this point there's no way I'm going to be able to finish these games in order before Civ VI comes out, so I think what I'll probably do is my first game of Civ VI will be a Aztec game to take advantage of the fact that I pre-ordered, and then when I get there I'll play Chinese to continue this 25th Anniversary thing. Anyway, please remember to donate. This is for the kids, and it really means so much to me if you've seen the pre-roll video. And other than that, I'll see you next time. Bye. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you want to see more of my videos, be sure to click the subscribe button. I also enjoy comments, so feel free to leave one below. I have a pretty eclectic channel, so here on the right you'll see a selection of other videos you might enjoy.